Nowadays, more and more English teachers force their students to produce videocasts. It's getting a really important topic in schools, so it's time to talk about it. Many students don't know how to produce a really good videocast. So our aim today is to protect the world of any further bad videocasts. Before you start to make a videocast, you need the right equipment. First, you need a video camera, maybe a microphone, and a computer with a video processing program. Then you need an interesting scene for your video cast, and you need to develop something like a screenplay before you start shooting. Then you need a fitting location and some people who are willing to participate in your video. When you have all your equipment together, you can start shooting. But there are some more aspects you have to pay attention to. First, you need a stable and secure camera work. Do not shake the camera and do not make too fast panning movements. As well, you have to use the zoom correctly. Do not zoom in and out too much. Do not zoom in too close and do not zoom out too far. The zoom should be used the way that everything is good visible. Then you also have to pay attention to the lighting conditions. Make sure that everything is in the right light what you want to show. While you shoot, there should be no disturbing noises in the background. Otherwise, you may not understand everything that is said. Furthermore, the people in front of the camera should pay attention to speak clearly and to use proper English. In the end, you have to intercut all the scenes properly. And you have to find a short and matching title for your videocast. Now you will see our example of a videocast.
From FIFA Talk. Today we are in London and have a meeting with Michael Ballack. I'm really looking forward to see him and maybe get some insider information. So let us go.
Oh!
Mike!
Hello, Julie! Come in, please.
Oh, it's nice to see you.
Ah, it's nice to see you, too.
Michael.
Yeah?
Thanks a lot for your invitation. We haven't seen each other for about 2 years, and it's really nice to see you again, and your hair has grown longer.
You're welcome, yeah? It grows very fast, actually.
Wow. Michael, I was shocked when I heard that you hurt yourself and cannot play for Germany in the FIFA World Cup. What happened?
Well, I think it was the end of May, in the English Cup final, when a guy named Boateng fouled me and he hurt my upper ankle joint.
Fuck!
That's a pity, Kevin Prince Boateng.
And what do you do to support your team in Africa while you are here in London?
Well, I have email contact with them, and I tell the guys how they did their jobs, and I give them suggestions how they can improve the game.
Oh, very good. And where do you watch the games?
Well, normally I watch them at home, and yeah, that's what I do. So, when you are at home alone, you can better concentrate on the game.
Ah, okay. I think I would do it in the same way. And how do you feel about not being able to play?
Yeah, it's a strange feeling, but I think I handle it in a good way.
Yes, a thousand thanks for your invitation. It was very, very nice to see you again. And hopefully your upper ankle joint is going better and you can play quickly again.
Thanks, Julie. I hope so too. Okay. Bye.
Bye. This was a great interview with Michael Balak. We will see each other next week on FIFA Talk. And don't forget, play soccer, don't suffer. Now you may decide if this was a good video cast or not. Maybe it was just an illusion. Did we really pay attention to everything you should pay attention to? The decision is now up to you. Your Joanna Frakes. Goodbye, Michael.